Morning students, today we are going to start a new chapter in physics which will be laws of motion, which is chapter number 3, and this chapter is going to be very interesting for you as we can come to know scientific reasons behind certain examples that we come across to in our daily life. For example, why do the passengers tends to fall backward when the train or the bus suddenly starts? Same way, why does a person or a passenger tends to fall in the forward direction when suddenly the brakes are applied on a moving bus? What is the reason that when we want to take catch to a ball, we tend to take our hands back in order to take the catch properly? So there are various reasons and various examples where we have certain logics and scientific reasons behind, which actually works on some principles or laws given in physics. So before coming to all those examples, we are actually going to start with the effect of force first, because whatever examples generally we come across to in our daily life, in one way or the other, it is due to the force applied on it. So effects of force can bring about two kinds of effects. It changes the state of a body. Changes the state of the body means it can either bring the moving body into rest, or you can set a stationary body into motion. For example, you might have seen when the train moves, in order to stop the train, we have to, or the driver has to, apply the brake on it. So this brakes, when applied, the driver is applying the force to bring the train into rest. Same is the case if the body is at rest, we have to apply force on that body to bring the body into motion. So force can change the state of body. The state of body can be state of rest or the state of motion. Second, the force can also change the dimensions of the body. That means it can change the shape and size of the body. When you take an inflated balloon, when you apply force on the balloon, you find the shape of the balloon changes. Coming to two types of body, that is rigid and non-rigid body. So we can classify the body into two on the basis of the intermolecular space. I'm not talking about solid, liquid or gas. Here we are talking about only the solid body, but even solid body can differ in intermolecular space. So if the intermolecular space is very close, with very small gap in between, then we can keep that body or say that body as a rigid body. And if the intermolecular space is little bit far, that is more, then we can say the body is non-rigid body. Now what happens when we apply force to these two kinds of bodies? When we apply force to a rigid body, there is no change in the intermolecular space between. But due to that force, the body will come into motion. On the other hand, when you apply force on the non-rigid body, as you know, non-rigid body already has some space between the molecules. So when we apply force, there will be change in the intermolecular space. That is, the molecules will start coming closer. So there will be change in intermolecular space, but at the same time, it will also send, that is, the force will also bring the body into motion. So non-rigid body will experience two kinds of changes. There will be change in intermolecular space, and there will also be change in the motion of the body. So let us now come to the next part of this chapter. Now coming to kinds of forces. So there are two kinds of forces. One is contact force and the other is non-contact force. So we can define contact force as the forces which is applied on the body by making physical contact. That means there will be the two bodies will be in contact with each other, and when there is no contact between the two bodies, the force applied will be non-contact force. So we have some examples of contact force. We are going to deal today with the three types of contact force, though we have more. We have the first contact force as a frictional force, normal reaction force, tension force. Let us see when are these forces going to play important role and can exert on the body. So frictional force, this is the force generally take place on a moving body. That is, whenever a body moves or rolls over a rough surface, a force will be exerted in the direction opposite to the moving or opposite to the motion of a body. For example, if this is the body moving in the forward direction, then there will be another force acting in the direction opposite to the motion. So this force acting in the direction opposite to the moving body will be called the frictional force. And you should know that frictional force always is applied to stop the body or to decrease the velocity of the body. Now normal reaction force. So when we keep a body or book on the table, the book exerts downward force equal to the weight of the book, but you find that the book does not move. The reason is that the table top also exerts a force opposite to the weight of the book. For example, if this is the table, suppose, and this is the book placed on it, then this book is going to exert a force in the downward direction, and this force will be the weight of the body or weight of the book. But do you find the book falling below? It does not, because there is one more force acting in the opposite direction of this weight, and this weight is the reaction. So we call this force as normal reaction force, because this force is reacting to this force which is equal to the weight of the body. You might have noticed when you hold any body on your hand like this, then your body or your hand experiences the force due to the weight of the body placed on the palm. But in order to keep that body upright or intact, not to let the body to move, you have to apply the force in the upward direction. This is normal reaction force. Then we have a tension force. Tension force is applied when you suspend any body with the help of a string. Again, you find this body, because of the weight, will exert force in the downward direction. But at the same time, it is also found that even this string exerts a force in the opposite direction to this weight. And this force exerted in the opposite direction, here the direction is the upward direction, this force is called the tension force. So here tension force is opposite to the weight of the body. You might have noticed that when the string suddenly breaks, you find this string tends to move up. The broken part of the string tends to move up. It is because of the tension force that is being exerted in the upward direction. So these are the various important things we have discussed today. Your homework will be to learn these important terms and the definitions. Thank you.